You have chosen diagram D, that the tensile force is constant for some amount of time, then increases slightly at a constant rate until it reaches some position in time later in which it's constant again. This answer is correct. Let's explain what's happening. We have the weight of the object acting downwards, and both tension as well as the buoyant force is acting upwards. Now we're going to neglect drag since the velocity of the object can affect the drag force as well as the density of the fluid. Since the buoyant force and weight are constant for the lure underwater, the tension in the line will be constant. So this part's true. Now, as the lure starts transferring here from being partly underwater to starting to appear in our air and above the lake surface, our buoyant force is going to decrease. And this is going to decrease proportional to the volume of the lure that is being removed, because our buoyant force is equal to our specific weight of the fluid times the volume of the fluid that we displace. So as we start pulling that lure out, we're displacing less volume, and we're going to do that proportional to how it's being pulled out. So we'll have a decrease of the buoyant force, and as we have a decrease of the buoyant force, we'd expect that the tensile force would increase. Now once this lure is completely out of the water, we will go back to having a constant tensile force since both the buoyant force and the weight forces are constant.